So we are going to start chemistry classes. In this session we'll be discussing about P block elements. So we have started with P block elements during our special classes, and we have covered with group 15, and we have completed group 16 till dioxygen. So some more topics to be covered in group 16, which I'll be covering in this video session. So all of you who are all watching it, you can take out your Part 1 Chemistry NCERT textbook. In that P block elements, we will be starting with ozone. So have a pen or pencil with you so that you can underline the necessary points, and you can make a note of the questions I am giving you people, and you can learn that. So ozone, its molecular formula is O3, and it is formed from atmospheric oxygen in the presence of sunlight. And you know about ozone that it protects our earth from the harmful ultraviolet radiations. And you also know that now what all we are facing, isn't it? Due to ozone depletion, what all is happening. We are not anyway going deep into it. Now we will start with how ozone is prepared. I hope you have all taken your textbook and open up that page of ozone. Look on to the preparation. So you can see that when a slow dry stream of oxygen is passed through a silent electrical discharge, conversion of oxygen to ozone occurs. So here the point to be noted that we are using a silent electrical discharge. Now look on to that equation given in your textbook. O2 is converted to O3 and delta H is equal to positive 142 kilojoules per mole. What does that positive sign for delta H indicate? It indicates that this reaction is endothermic. Since it is an endothermic reaction, here heat is taken in, isn't it? So if more heat is there, what will happen? This ozone will decompose to oxygen. So in order to prevent the decomposition of ozone, we are giving a silent electrical discharge. So you can underline that point over there. Since the formation of ozone from oxygen is an endothermic process, it is necessary to use a silent electrical discharge in its preparation to prevent its decomposition. So you can make a note of a question over here. Give reason. A silent electrical discharge is used in the preparation of ozone from oxygen. I repeat the question again. A silent electrical discharge is used in the preparation of ozone from oxygen. So, answer for that question, the point which we have underlined, in order to prevent the decomposition of ozone. And you know why it decomposes, because formation of oxygen, ozone from oxygen is an endothermic reaction. That is why we are using a silent electrical discharge. I hope it is clear to all. Next, we move on to its properties. First, let us look on to its physical properties. How does it look like? So it is a pale blue gas, dark blue liquid and a violet black solid. And it has a characteristic smell. In small concentration, it is harmless. And the concentration of ozone is very high. What happens is breathing becomes uncomfortable and there can be headache and nausea. So this is the condition of what happens if ozone is in high concentration. So this is about their physical properties. Next we move on to their chemical properties. So we have seen that how ozone is formed. It is formed from oxygen. And the formation of ozone from oxygen, we have seen that it is an endothermic process. So the backward reaction, that is the decomposition of ozone to oxygen, it will be, what type of a process it will be, we have learnt in our equilibrium chapter, isn't it? So if the forward reaction is endothermic, automatically the backward reaction will be exothermic. So here, since it is an exothermic reaction, delta H, it will be negative. So we can tell that ozone is thermodynamically unstable with respect to oxygen. Because why? It's decomposition. Decomposition of ozone, what it will, we will get? We will get oxygen. So due at this time, delta H will be negative. So delta H, that is change in enthalpy, will be negative. And there is an increase in entropy. Entropy, that is delta S. It will be positive. When delta H is negative and delta S is positive, the Gibbs free energy delta G will be negative. Gibbs free energy negative means what it is? The reaction is a spontaneous reaction. So we can tell that ozone, if it is in very high concentration, what will happen? Its decomposition will result in the formation of oxygen. And we have seen that delta H will be negative, delta S will be positive, and delta G will be negative. So we can tell that high concentration of ozone can be dangerously explosive because delta G is negative. The reaction is spontaneous reaction. Okay, so I'll just go through it. Ozone is thermodynamically unstable with respect to oxygen. Please underline that in your textbook. Ozone is thermodynamically unstable with respect to oxygen since its decomposition into oxygen results in the liberation of heat. So when heat is liberated, that is delta H is negative, and an increase in entropy, that is delta S is positive. These two effects reinforce each other, resulting in large negative Gibbs energy change. That is delta G is negative for its conversion into oxygen. Therefore, high concentrations of ozone can be dangerously explosive. Okay, so make a note of give reason question. So the question, you can make a note of it. High concentration of ozone can be dangerously explosive. Give reason. Or the question can be asked like this. Ozone is thermodynamically unstable. Give reason. For both these questions, answer is same. That is, decomposition of ozone, it is an exothermic reaction. Therefore, delta H is negative. Delta S is positive. And Gibbs free energy, which results due to the effects of reinforce of each other, delta G, H and delta S, will be highly negative. So the reaction will be a spontaneous reaction. So you may, can make a no, underline those points in your textbook. Next, chemical property. So decomposition of ozone, O3, gives O2 plus O. So one is diatomic oxygen, the other one is O. That is oxygen. It is called as a nascent oxygen. There will be an electron on it which makes it a very reactive oxygen. That is why it is called as nascent oxygen. That is due to the ease with which it liberates atoms of nascent oxygen, ozone acts as a powerful oxidizing agent. So underline that, due to the ease with which it liberates atoms of nascent oxygen. In the bracket you can see O3 giving O2 plus O. It acts as a powerful oxidizing agent. So next question, make a note of it. In text question 7.18, why ozone acts as a powerful oxidizing agent? Answer, due to the ease with which it liberates atoms of nascent oxygen, it acts as a powerful oxidizing agent. Now, if they are asking how, with an example, you can prove that it acts as a powerful oxidizing agent, you can look onto your textbook. For example, it oxidizes lead sulfide to lead sulfate and iodide ions to iodine. So, in the equation, you can see PbS plus OH3 gives PbSO4 plus 4O2. That is, lead sulfide is being converted to lead sulfate. And the other example, iodide 2I minus plus O3 gives I2 plus O2. So you can see over there, iodide is converted to iodine. So if they are asking, give example to show that it acts as a powerful oxidizing agent, any one of the example with equation you can give. So learn both the equations. Next is, how can we know how much amount of ozone is present? So for quantitative process, we are doing titration in our lab. So here, when ozone reacts with an excess of potassium iodide solution, iodine will be liberated. One thing to be noted that this solution should be buffered using a borated buffer. Buffer is the one solution that resists the change in pH. So to avoid the change in pH, we are adding borated buffer. So here when potassium iodide and ozone reacts, iodine is liberated, and this liberated iodine, it is titrated against sodium thiosulfate. And from calculations we can find out how much ozone is present. The quantity of ozone can be known. So this is the next in-text question. How can we estimate ozone quantitatively? So underline that when ozone reacts with an excess of potassium iodide solution buffered with a borated buffer, iodine is liberated, which can be titrated against a standard solution of sodium thiosulfate. This is a quantitative method for estimating ozone gas. So I hope the question is clear to you people. Next, we are going to discuss about ozone depletion. So you have learned that ozone gets depleted and ozone holes are formed through which harmful UV radiations reach the earth, and which is very harmful to us. So one which you would have learned is ozone gets depleted due to the high use of rayons and all, isn't it? Another one is in the atmosphere, the supersonic jet planes which move around above the stratosphere, one of the exhaust from it is nitrogen oxide. This nitrogen oxide can combine with oxygen and we can get NO2 plus O2. NO2 plus O2. So over there O3 is decomposed. So it gets depleted. So this is another reason for ozone depletion. So experiments have shown that nitrogen oxides, that is nitric oxide, combine very rapidly with ozone, and the possibility that nitrogen oxides emitted from the exhaust system of supersonic jet planes slowly deplete the concentration of ozone layer in the atmosphere. So equation is given in the textbook. NO plus O3 gives NO2 plus O2. Then another threat to ozone layer is by the use of freons, which is used in aerosol sprays and as refrigerants. So this is about how ozone gets depleted. Explain how ozone gets depleted. Next question, you can make a note of it. Next is the structure of ozone, which is given in your textbook. You can see a resonance hybrid of O3 is given. So draw that structure. So the two oxygen bond lengths in ozone molecule are identical, and the molecule is angular with a bond angle of 117 degree. So learn how to draw the resonance hybrid structure of ozone. So with this, ozone is completed.